Okay, so today we're going to be taking a look at multiplying terms. This is a topic actually that leads on from another video we did recently in collecting like terms. If you haven't seen that video yet, if you want to check it out, I'll leave a link in the description and also a card in the top right corner if you want to check that out. Okay, so the first couple of questions are actually where we're adding terms. So this is going back to what I was talking about a second ago with collecting like terms. So for the first one, we've got a plus a. We know when we add terms, we're actually affecting the coefficient, the number that goes in front. So for example, if I add a plus a, that would just simply be two lots of a, so 2a. Okay, similar thing for the next one. This time though, I've got b plus b plus b. So I'm affecting the coefficient, the bit in front of the b. So how many b's have we got? We've got three lots of b. So b plus b plus b would simply be three lots of b. Or 3b. When we multiply terms, we're actually affecting the indice or the power. So for this next question down, I've actually got a multiplied by a. So this time, because I'm multiplying the terms, I know I'm affecting the indice. So a multiplied by a, I've got two of them, so this would actually be a to the power of 2 or a squared. Okay, looking at the next question, this time we've got b multiplied by b multiplied by b. So we're dealing with b, and because we're multiplying our term, we know it's affecting the indice. So it's essentially now looking how many times we've got this letter b. So we've got it three times, so b multiplied by b would actually be b to the power of 3, which is also known as b cubed. Okay, brilliant, I hope that made sense. Now let's have a look at some more questions. Okay, feel free to pause the video at this point if you want to have a go at these, and we'll go through them in just a few seconds. Okay, for this first question, I've got 5a multiplied by a. Well, I know 5a means 5 multiplied by a, so I'm going to break that down into that. And then I've got to multiply it by a again. So we've got 5 multiplied by a multiplied by a again. Well, let's look at those a's first. We know that a multiplied by a is a squared. So essentially, I've got 5 multiplied by a squared. So I've got 5 times a squared. So then all we do is we hide that multiplication sign, put it all together. The final answer for that would be 5a squared. Okay, for this next question, we've got 4b times 6b. So 4b means 4 multiplied by b. And then we're going to multiply that by 6b, which again means 6 multiplied by b. So the whole thing through is multiplication, so let's combine the terms we can. So we've got 4 multiplied by 6, which is 24. And it's all multiplication, so we're going to multiply that by b multiplied by b is b squared, so b to the power of 2. So I've got 24 times b squared. All I do now is hide the multiplication sign, so that is just 24b squared. Okay, for this next question, I've got 3c, which again means 3 multiplied by c. And then I've got to multiply that by 7d, which is 7 multiplied by d. So again, all multiplication all the way through. Let's combine the terms we can. So in terms of the numbers, we've got 3 times 7, which is 21. We're then multiplying that by c, and then we're multiplying that by d. All right, we can't simplify those terms anymore, so that's the final bit we can get it to. So all we need to do now is combine it all together. So the final answer to this question would be 21cd. Okay, for the next question, we've got 2e, which is 2 multiplied by e. We're then multiplying that by 3e, which again is 3 multiplied by e. And then we're multiplying that by 5e, so 5 multiplied by e. So let's deal with the numbers first. We've got 2 multiplied by 3, which is 6, multiplied by 5, which is 30, so that's 30. And then we're multiplying that by our terms of e. We've got e times e times e. There's 3 of them, so that's e to the power 3, or e cubed. So our final answer would just be 30 e to the power 3. Okay, well done if you got all them right, and let's look at some more difficult examples. Okay, so for our next question, we've got 3a squared multiplied by 4a cubed. So this looks a lot more difficult, but all we're going to do is exactly the same as we did in the previous questions. We're going to write it out a bit more in depth just to make it a bit easier to break down. So for our first bit, we've got 3a squared, which means 3 multiplied by a squared. But we also know that a squared is a multiplied by a. So instead of writing a multiplied by a squared, I'm going to write a multiplied by a. So we've got 3a squared is the same as 3 multiplied by a multiplied by a. Okay, now we're going to do the same thing for the next bit. We've got 4a cubed. So we're multiplying by 4, and we know that a cubed is just a multiplied by itself 3 times. So then I'm going to multiply by a, multiply by a, and multiply by a again. Okay, so now all we do, again, it's multiplication all the way through. We're just going to multiply the numbers and the letters that we see. So we've got 3 multiplied by 4, which is 12. And then in terms of our a, what have we got? We've got a multiplied by a, multiplied by a, multiplied by a, multiplied by a. So we're multiplying by a, and there's 5 of them, so that's going to affect the indices, so it's to the power of 5. So then to finish that off, we just hide the multiplication sign, so our final answer would just simply be 12a to the power of 5. Okay, let's have a look at some final few questions. Okay, feel free to pause the video at this point if you want to have a go at these, and we'll go through them in just a few seconds. Okay, for our first one, we have 5a squared, which is the same as saying 5 multiplied by a multiplied by a, and we're going to times that by 3a squared, so 3 multiplied by a multiplied by a. Okay, so collecting the terms again, we've got 5 multiplied by 3, which is 15, and then I'm going to times that by a, and how many have we got? Well, we've got a times a times a times a, so that's going to be a to the power of 4. The final answer for that one would be 15a to the power of 4. Okay, for our next question, we've got 3b, so 3 multiplied by b, and then we're timesing that by 3b squared, so that would be 3 times, and b squared is b times b. So in terms of the numbers, we've got 3 times 3, which is 9, and we're multiplying that by b times b times b, so we've got b to the power of 3. So our final answer would be 9b cubed. Okay, for our next question, we've got 5c to the power of 3 multiplied by 4d to the power of 4. So you can see in this question, we've got terms of c in the first bit and then terms of d in the second bit. So we're not going to actually have terms that we can combine together here. So I'm going to leave this one with their indices intact. So 5c to the power of 3 is just 5 times c to the power of 3. And then I'm multiplying that by 4d to the power of 4, which is 4 multiplied by d to the power of 4. So again, let's find the terms that we can combine. So we've got 5 multiplied by 4, which is 20. Then we've got c to the power of 3, which we're multiplying by. And then we're multiplying by d to the power of 4. So we can't actually combine those terms together, so they'll just go side by side. So our final answer for that one would be 20 c to the 3 d to the 4. Okay, for our final question today, we've got 3e squared multiplied by 2e cubed multiplied by 10 e to the power of 5. So if we break these down again, we've actually got 3 times e times e, which is 3e squared. We've then got to multiply this by 2e cubed, which is 2 multiplied by e multiplied by e multiplied by e. And then we've got 10e to the power of 5, which is 10 multiplied by e times e times e times e times e. Okay, so to finish this question off then, let's combine everything we can. Well, we've got 3. This is all multiplication, so we've got 3 multiplied by 2, which is 6, multiplied by 10, which is 60. And then we're multiplying that by e, and how many have we got? It's going to be the power, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're multiplying by e to the power of 10. So our final answer for this question would just be 60 e to the power of 10. Okay, that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If you've got any questions, please leave them in the comments. And if there's any specific topics you'd like me to go over next, please just let me know. Well, again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.